线上的朋友大家好，您现在观赏的是全民开讲终结甲癌系列从天而降的国际人权两公约12集。我是今天的主持人 Jill。 民主自由的社会绝对需要严整的法治来维系人权的保障。台湾号称是亚洲民主的灯塔，为了与世界接轨，在2009年底实行国际人权两公约并国内法化，到今年2022年已经第13年了。然而在台湾，有多少人关注台湾实行两公约的现况呢？台湾实行国际两公约的成绩单又是如何呢？今年的5月9日到13日，在台湾进行国际人权两公约第三次国家报告国际审查会议。让我们来听听第三度来台审查的国际审查委员语重心长的心声。
I have always asked how Taiwan thinks about what Taiwan thinks about the Universal Declaration on Human Rights in particular and about human rights education in general. So mind you, this is now the third time that I have been here. On the average, that's what? At least 10 years, right? From the first time that I came here. And up to now, I feel like a failure. And you know why? Nobody seems to be interested in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Without the Universal Declaration on Human Rights, there would be no international covenant on civil and political rights, nor would there be a covenant on economic, social, and cultural rights, and all the others that followed after.
The two covenants have been in force in Taiwan for 13 years. However, they simply exist in name. Human rights are not being respected in government agencies. Over the years, the international reviewers' concluding observations and recommendations have not been taken seriously. The two covenants have yet to achieve the same power of the Constitution of Taiwan and basic human rights guaranteed by the Constitution, such as the right to effective remedies, anti-torture, and freedom of religion and belief, have not been implemented.
是的，两公约在台湾实行13年了，却只是图具表象的空壳，人权观念并未真正落实于政府机关。历年来，国际审查委员所提出的结论性意见都未受到重视。两公约未接亦未给予宪法所保障的宗教、信仰、自由权利之有效救济，反复行等基本人权仍未落实。司法是正义的最后一道防线，税法是国家发展运作的基石。然而号称亚洲民主灯塔的台湾，是否灯火暗淡，快要熄灯了呢？在2022年的两公约审查会议中，有许多台湾各界与会的代表，针对宗教、信仰、自由、权利之有效救济，以及反复行等问题，对审查委员提出台湾的种种不可思议的乱象。
European Times 欧洲这边的时报杂志，其实有非常多的国际专家学者在讨论这个太极门这个严重的宗教信仰自由迫害案件。那其中呢，也有两本书，这个寒冬杂志，光是一年多就已经有100多位的国际学者专家针对这个案件做评论，并指呢，这个是 FORB Freedom of Religion or Belief Not a Tax Case
The NHRC, they should receive individual complaint, investigate or to urge the relevant authority to resolve these cases. But the method of the investigation by the National Human Rights Commission, we observe that a recent case, a complaint regarding tax abuse of National Taxation Bureau and Enforcement Agency was treated by the commission by simply asking the commentof the accused executive branch, and then using the reply, the comment of the NTB as the conclusion, and replied to the people that this complaint was not accepted. So I would like to ask that, does this violate the principle and also the independence of the commission?
我有一封信要给各位的委员，这是关于太极门案件的真相。真正在台湾已经将近十年的这个国际人权两公约实行到现在，所有上述的救济制度并没有符合公正公约第二条，人民有救济的这样的权利。恳请我们的委员能够深入的调查评估两公约在台湾执行的情况，谢谢。
那其他 NGO 有讲到，我们现在的国家人权委员会其实没有符合巴黎原则的功能。那就因为台湾的司法及国际人权单位对人权的保护不足，导致台湾政府在公正公约第二条的有效救济无法实现。
If there is something that you really, really mean is important, why don't you write to your now you have a National Human Rights Commission? Write to them, explain things to them. They have the right to be able to deal with your issues.
在结论性意见中，审查委员会强烈建议国家人权委员会确认最紧迫的人权问题，处理侵犯人权的投诉，就相关的国际人权标准及将其纳入立法，向行政院及立法院提出建议并公开这些建议，持续审查长期存在的侵犯个人人权指控，接受类似于国家人权机构全球联盟认证小组委员会的认证程序，评估其遵守巴黎原则的情况。
是司法跟课税不能迫害人民的生存权，我们要求要为所有受灾户平反，也落实两公约的精神，实现转型正义。
国家的法治、社会的正义、人权的维护不容破坏。太极门乃古老气功武术修行团体，秉持以心为根本、气为基础，讲求修养德性、培养正气，让身心常保平衡。在新兴社会，弟子在太极门修习气功，练好身体，修养心性，改善脾气，把自己练好，再推己及人，影响周遭的人。然而，在1996年12月19日，太极门师徒遭到公权力与法税暴力进行宗教信仰自由的人权迫害。这是一起由侯藩仁检察官无中生有制造的假案。当年在检察官一手主导下，找苏元史月生配合作伪证，以假证人、假证据、诬耻构陷不实罪名滥权起诉。违法侦办。在2007年7月13日最高法院三审判决太极门无罪无欠税确定。万万没想到，太极门在刑事法庭三审无罪之后，已经15年仍无法获得真正的公平与正义。不合理的法税制度竟沦为公权力用来破坏人权、破坏社会正义与阻碍国家发展的绊脚石。在太极门假案，国税局虽将其中五个年度税金金额更正为零，却用1992年度的违法税单与行政执行署联手违法拍卖太极门的修行道场预定地，还非法收归国有，让司法正义荡然无存。这种严重破坏国家威信、破坏民主法治的问题，更让国内外学者专家挺身而出，为正义发声。让我们来听听以下这位驻伦敦的人权律师兼欧洲信仰自由协会主席的发言。
Hello, I'm Alex Amicarelli, a London-based human rights lawyer, a friend of Taiwan, and a friend of Taiji Men. As you may know, only 14 countriesworldwide recognize Taiwan as an independent country and so have official diplomatic relations with Taipei, the only European country being the only sea also known as the Vatican. Taiwan, in an effort to be accepted into the wider international community, back in 2009 passed a bill to transport the content of the two United Nations International Covenants of 1966 into the national system along with other treaties. This was an extremely brave action that the human rights community appreciated and praised. We must not forget that turning from a martial law system to democracy is not an easy process, and it requires additional efforts and several steps to take. So far, Taiwan did a great job. And that was not an easy one, as when you are not internationally recognized as a sovereign country, as Taiwan is not internationally recognized, and your neighbor China, that is against your independence, everything is tougher. Taiwan was proud and brave, and we appreciate it. But there is a but. Ghosts from the past keep damaging the process of democratization of Taiwan. And of course, in this context, I hint at the Tai Shiman case that we all know about. And if you don't know much about it, you can find further information on a very extensive platform, www.taishimancase.org, where you will find videos, academic papers, information about future events, and much more. We do take our work seriously, and we expect that the Taiwanese authorities take our work seriously too. We, as scholars, experts, representatives of different international human rights organizations, and as friends of Taiwan, we love Taiwan, and we do expect that the Taiwanese authorities help us help Taiwan in the process of wider acceptance by the international community.
2022年是台湾重要的选举年，人民要用选票决定自己的未来。国际两公约施行至今13年，人权倒退路的公权力酷刑仍然存在。面对国际越来越多专家学者对台籍门案件的声援，台湾这个亚洲民主灯塔需要重新被点亮。希望改革不再只是选举口号，而能真正被落实，让国家得以发展，让人民能够安居乐业。在此期盼唤醒政府官员的良心，帮助台湾真正的与国际人权接轨，而不是一直在大张旗鼓的纸上谈兵。感谢您今天的收看。